G'day everyone, this is Discovering Ultibo, episode 3, and it's Garry from Ultibo.org here. We're going to do something a little different today. We're going to do building the Rtl. Now, to some of you that might sound a little intimidating, scary. Why would you want to do that? Well, there are many reasons why you might want to rebuild the Rtl for Ultibo. Biggest one is to get access to new features as they become available. We'll be putting out updates and fixes to the Rtl, you know, every few days, every couple of weeks, pretty regularly anyway. And we'll only be updating the Lazarus installer maybe every few months at sort of the most. So the simplest way to get yourself up to date with all the latest features is to actually update your Rtl. It's not that hard to do. We've made the process pretty simple and straightforward, and we're just going to run through it today and explain a bit along the way why certain things are the way they are. So we're not actually going to use the Pi. We've got it here running a little demo. You might have noticed that the font handling in Ultibo's had quite a bit of enhancement lately, and just for fun we've created a little demo scrolling a couple of different size fonts in the screen in colours. So that's just a bit of fun. You can try it out yourself. It's quite easy to do with all the new font enhancements. So we'll move over to the computer and we'll open up Lazarus. And first question with building the Rtl or rebuilding the Rtl is, what version do you already have? So I've got installed here the latest release version of Lazarus, and the simplest and quickest way to figure out what version you're up to is to create a new project. So we go new project and choose any type of project, select the global const unit, right click on it, and go find declaration of global const. That will actually open the unit in a new tab, and then you can just scroll down to the head a bit, and the very first thing that comes up is the version information about Ultibo. So the release date, the release name, which is currently Cucumber but will increment to something else soon, and the actual release version. So right now I'm on 1.2.009. So that's the quickest way to find out your version and whether you're up to date. So if I now go and close Lazarus, and we'll bring up Firefox to the Ultibo homepage, and we'll just scroll down to the very bottom of the page where you find all the links to all of our different sites, and we'll click on the GitHub link. And then we'll select the core repository, and it takes us to Ultibo Core. So this is all the source for Ultibo Core. Latest version always brings up by default. And over on the right, there's a button for clone or download. So if we click that and we go download zip, it'll provide us with a zip file of the latest version of the code. We can go OK on save file, choose somewhere to save to, see downloads I like, and the file name is Core Master. Now that's not very big, so by the time I bring up the progress bar, it's already completed. We can clear that and put Firefox away. Now if I go to computer, C drive, downloads, and there's my Core Master zip that I just downloaded. I can double click that and open it up, and there's a Core Master folder inside, and inside that is a source folder. Inside source is RTL, and inside RTL is Ultibo. Now where do we copy that to? So if we bring up another window and move it over to the left here and go to where Ultibo is installed, which normally is Ultibo Core, you'll find all these folders. Under FPC, which is Free Pascal Compiler 3.1, source, we find RTL, and then down the list a little bit, we find Ultibo. That's the same folder as what's in our zip. So we can simply take the Ultibo folder from the zip, copy that, paste it in the RTL folder under source, And when Windows prompts us for replacing the folder, we say yes. And it'll prompt again, do you want to replace all the files? We say yes, do that for all of them. Copy and replace. And it asks again, do you want to replace all the folders? And we say yes, again. So a couple of seconds, it copies all that across. And that's done. Now, we have the latest source. We can close that. We can close that one as well. But we have to update the RTL by rebuilding it so that we can use the new source. So we'll open up Lazarus again. And we've conveniently provided, under Tools menu in Lazarus, a Build Ultibo RTL tool. You click on that. And we come up with the Ultibo RTL Builder window. Now, by default, it's got both platforms selected, so for Raspberry Pi A and A plus and 0, and also for the Raspberry Pi 2B and 3B. You can choose to build one or the other, but it's quite simple just to build them both at once. So if we're happy to go ahead, we click on the Build button, and that will start the process of building the RTL. Now, that takes a couple of minutes, so while that's happening, I'm just going to minimize Lazarus and bring up a little diagram that we've created. Just explain, what is the RTL? Well, obviously the RTL is the runtime library. And in many instances, it's the code that your program interfaces with, the services that you use. So in this little diagram, this is a typical Ultibo application. Right at the bottom level, we've got the hardware, the Raspberry Pi itself, and any USB devices you have, maybe other things like LCD displays and things. They're the hardware. Above that, we have some of the boot code and the compiler magic to make it all hang together. And above that is the runtime library and all the drivers. So things like the console, the USB drivers, the GPIO and serial drivers, even the drivers for the network and the file system all fall into the runtime library and drivers. Above that, we can have packages, which might include some of the free Pascal packages like FCL Image or even things like FPGUI, which we're working on, Synapse, a third-party internet sockets library. Above that, we have your program code. And I know what you're thinking right now is, hang on, don't we get direct access to the hardware in Ultibo? And the answer, of course, is yes. You can interface with any of the layers below your program code. You don't always have to interface directly with the hardware, and that's why Ultibo's different to some other things. You can use a lot of the services directly out of the runtime library and use the drivers without having to know what they're doing talking to the hardware. You can just use it as is. So it gives you a little bit of a rundown of where the runtime library fits in the whole process and why it is actually so important. So we keep updating the runtime library with new features, new drivers, new capabilities, and fixing bugs at the same time, and your program code takes advantage of it every time you rebuild the runtime library. So we'll just go back to our RTL Builder tool and we'll see where it's up to. And you see it displays a lot of messages on the screen, but it is working its way through quite a lot of compiling as it goes. And we're waiting basically till it comes up and says build completed, and then we'll be able to go ahead and actually use the new functionality. So, of course, you don't have to sit there and watch it. You can simply click build, walk away for a couple of minutes, and come back. So here we see on the screen, build RTL completed successfully, completed build. And that's what you're looking for. If for any reason an error did occur, it'll actually inform you on the screen. You'll get a message to say an error occurred and some error output. Now, it's always best to check what you did. Did you, you know, copy things to the right places? Did you accidentally overwrite something you shouldn't have before you sort of try again? And if you get stuck, please post in the forum. So now we can close the RTL Builder and go back to Lazarus. And it's best at this point to go restart on Lazarus. And let's do that exercise again. We'll go project, new project, and we'll go 2B again. Our global const unit, find declaration, and now if we scroll down through the header, you find that we're on 1.2.021. So we've updated our version. Our new empty Raspberry Pi 2 project, we can go run, compile, and we get success. That project won't do much, but it succeeded. You've got the new RTL, you're all up to date. So that's all there is for building the RTL. It's a pretty simple process, and it only takes you a couple of minutes, but it keeps you up to date and means you can use all the latest features all the time. Next time on Discovering Ultibo, come back and join us when we see what we can do with one of these. This is a breadboard, and we're going to do some GPIO. So, thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.